Hi guys, the topic of conversation today, as I've been asked my opinion on this topic, is the situation in Ferguson in Missouri. And it's very unfortunate because in the past year, traveling throughout North America and Australia and Europe, I've seen this quite a bit. And I believe in my own opinion, it honestly, is just an excessive use of force or an unreasonable and unnecessary use of force. Whether you're a civilian or you're a professional alike, you still need to respond, or what I like to call acting in a situation with reasonable, necessary use of force. Now, don't get me wrong, nobody's perfect. I can even say myself that I've been heavy-handed sometimes. Sometimes people are under so much stress. You could be at the end of a 12-hour shift, you might have done double shifts, you might have stress at home in your personal life, whatever. Any human being can fail under certain pressures, not just physical but mental, also emotional, whatever stress that we're under. That doesn't mean that any of these actions that have been taken against, in this case, the youth, the African American youth again, or in the other case in Toronto that I saw, or even just recently in New York with that big African American man, it was like 400 pounds or whatever, and it took so many cops to get him down. They sat on him, they had a headlock on him, I believe it was. I watched the video, I've just been traveling so much I can't remember the specifics, but to be honest with you, I look at all of these, and even another one that was shared last night from some footage of the NYPD taking down one male individual. There was like four or five, at least five actually, cops on them. There's all other cops standing around. One of them just beating him in the legs with a baton. I'm thinking, Jesus, like, it's reasonable and necessary for someone to intervene, a civilian, but they would most likely get the same treatment and the situation would become worse. But how do you even justify just getting out your camera and recording that shit? I mean, you've got to, I think that both parties are at fault here in terms of the professionals, as in law enforcement and civilians, because now you've got the extreme cases where civilians are, there's civil unrest, there's people that are fucking looting, and there's all this violence, and people are apparently getting shot with rubber bullets. I wasn't there, I haven't seen it, but that's the apparent situation. Tear gas is being used, and there's a heightened level of force. Now, maybe that's necessary because of the current situation, but obviously a youth dying because of him being stopped for questioning is obviously unnecessary. But again, I wasn't there in the situation, I don't know. I have been in situations where force has had to been used as a professional, and I can say that there's been a handful of times where I thought, shit, I didn't act in this situation appropriately. And I'm very lucky that I kept my freedom and so forth and so on. But anyway, all I'm saying is that I believe that, you know, even Obama said could have been today, yesterday, whatever, in the afternoon, he said that, you know, there has to be a review of police tactics or force, the use of force. Okay, and I think that is a very, very logical response, because that's the obvious problem here. You see a lot of this shit go down. The London police as well, you know, there's issues with them about 4 years ago, maybe even more now, but with riots and them just coming out with batons and military police getting involved and all this sort of thing. And I mean, what can you do? You know what I mean? But I think that people, yes, it is a very bad situation, but people are kind of taking the wrong sort of approach to how they protest about it. As I've said in my other videos, I don't believe that posting shit on Facebook and spreading hatred towards law enforcement officers is a positive thing at all. I don't think that's going to get you anywhere. I think that's only going to divide us and bring us further from our actual goal. I do work with a lot of police. I do work with a lot of professionals in the security and military. And, you know, it's just different everywhere you go. The stresses that these guys have to deal with on a constant basis, faced with a potential adversary all the time. And you know, some of them, just as fellow human beings, just tick differently, and then bam, it's just they make a wrong decision. Or, you know, a lot of cases where guns are involved, I think, fuck, this guy's supposedly a top trained cop. There was one that was a martial artist trained, this and that, and whatever, and he ended up shooting the guy in the chest on his wedding night. I just posted a video about it a few months back. I thought, fucking hell, like, one, there's that many people standing around to get it on camera, so that there's a fucking problem there. And two, police should be more trained in less lethal options, I believe. Okay, the use of force that's been used lately is obviously not warranted in a lot of cases, but you know, it's all avoidance and prevention. You know, you can always talk to someone, you can always calm them down, you can always gain and maintain a tactical position of advantage. And I know this from taking part in a lot of training and facilitating a lot of training and running a lot of drills and also being involved in these situations in a number of roles where, you know, you're dealing with active violence, an active threat against you, and complete non-compliance. Okay, in terms of a security role, for example, when I was working doors years ago, you know, they wouldn't dare push a cop a lot of the time, but they would surely take a swing at a bouncer. You know, so we at that point had a lot more experience in some ways than a lot of cops did on the street with violence, because they just didn't have to deal with any. They've got compliance spray, they've got a taser, and they've got the intimidation factor of just having those on them as well. Whereas at one point we were completely unarmed, had nothing, and you'd have just hundreds and hundreds of guys scrapping. But those were the days, eh? Point being is that, again, I've made some mistakes on the job. I've made some you know, rash sort of decisions that have led to situations where I thought, fucking hell, what am I going to do here? You know, and I think that these are just extreme cases of that. You know, you've got to look at these officers as fellow human beings to begin with. Yes, they've done the wrong thing. Yes, their actions were uncalled for. And yes, justice needs to be brought to. However, going around smashing up innocent people's businesses and committing acts of violence and rampaging the streets and fucking looting and whatever is just unnecessary. It's even more stupid than the actions taken, I believe, because unnecessary lives could be taken there too. You know, when things turn to shit, they turn even more shit real quick, and it's just all shades of shit from there. So, anyway, I'm hoping that, as people say, it gets worse before it gets better. It gets worse, as in it gets worse before it gets better. I'm hoping that we've seen the worst of it. I'm hoping that there's going to be some change. I'm happy to play a part in that if I can be involved with, as I do give force training, force on force, as in use of force training, to a number of professionals, as I said, security, law enforcement, military. However, it's just as important in the civil sort of sector, okay, in the private industry, because, you know, there's so many cases where people defend themselves and they take it sort of overboard and they get themselves in trouble. So, again, I guess the point of this video is reasonable, necessary use of force, being able to articulate your actions. So you've got to be right from the start. You've got to be trained properly from the start, but also implementing those concepts throughout your day-to-day life. Whether you're the average Joe, as I am now, or you're just... or you're a professional, you could be a fucking mall cop, you could be a active whatever in a tactical role, but you've got to be implementing your basics, your fundamentals in your day-to-day roles, in your operative sort of operational roles, okay? So that's my opinion on it all. I think a lot of people might not get what I'm saying or where I'm coming from on this. It's very hard when it's an outsider point of view. I'm not saying I've lived or experienced what these guys have. I haven't. I'm not even beginning to try to claim to understand what's going on, but that's just my opinion, that's my two cents. So yeah, thanks for watching. Make sure you have a look through my videos. There's online learning, there's a whole tactical membership on rawcombat.com. Got all sorts of tactical training, survival training, shooting, knife work, the lot. So check it out. There's a 3-week long trial. So if you haven't already, subscribe.